to the Quarantine Kitchen from Halle an der Saale, Germany. Tonya?
Hello.
Hey, we are going to prepare something quick, fresh, and delicious. It's one of our favorites. This is kind of a go-to for us when we want something like for breakfast sometimes. We'll make avocado toast with it, mm-hmm. or we want a snack in the afternoon. So what we're going to make is some guacamole, California style.
Yeah, and we use this too, like, if we make Mexican food, we oftentimes have guacamole on the side.
For sure. Yeah. It's a good, we've made this in large quantity too, when we have, like, a party. I remember when we were in Southern California and we would have, like, an outdoor pool party. We'd have chips, homemade salsa, and homemade guacamole.
Yep.
Personally, I find the guacamole that you can buy pre-made at the grocery stores a little bland for my taste.
Yeah, they're not as good.
Right. They're kind of made
You make really good guacamole.
Well, that's what you told me, and that's, I thought, okay, well...
But don't, like change the recipe, because you've got to do that sometimes. Just make it how you normally do, because that's what's delicious.
You know, the problem is that I've never really written down the recipe, so I use maybe different quantities each time. What I do know is that the recipe I have, it's 10 ingredients. So the ingredients that we're going to use, I have two really ripe avocado. They're very soft to the touch. I think that's important to have a nice ripe avocado. I'm gonna use a small tomato. I'm gonna dice the tomato very finely. We're using a lime. I'm gonna use probably the juice from half of this lime. We're gonna put in some fresh cilantro. Normally we would use fresh jalapeno peppers, and I would dice them, not even dice them, I would mince them very finely and put them in. This is going to give the guacamole
spicy
quite a bit of heat. Yeah. But what we have in the meantime is we have dried
fire peppers.
These would be fire peppers, red hot chili peppers. Look at how small these are, and I'm gonna use one. I'm gonna use one of these.
Yeah, please only use one, because they're very hot.
Remind me not to touch my face or my eyes, because it's like getting yourself pepper sprayed.
Yeah, for sure.
So we're gonna be very...
I used one of those the other night, and literally I was coughing in the kitchen because I had been like, I felt like I had been maced.
You maced yourself in the kitchen.
I did, yeah.
Okay, so we have the red hot chili peppers. I'm going to use some garlic powder. I'm going to use some onion powder. Now, I like my guacamole with freshly diced. Hold on.
No.
I know, Tonya, I know. I like my guacamole with fresh onion in it.
Gross.
Diced very finely. But Tonya doesn't like it.
I hate raw onion, like big chunks of raw onion.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to substitute the fresh onion for a tiny smidge of onion powder. So we got garlic
onion
powder.
Onion flavor is fine. I like to cook with onion. I cook with onion almost every meal.
Right.
And I like to cooked onion.
It's a mystery.
But the raw, crunchy, raw, really sharp onion, I can't do it.
It's a mystery to me. You don't like onions anywhere near your omelets. Really.
It's just onions don't go in certain things for me, like eggs.
How
onions
about,
do not go in eggs. I don't care what you say. They don't.
How about onions on a burger?
Well, I don't really eat burgers, but even so, I would, unless they were sautéed onions.
So you would do
grilled or sautéed, yeah.
In-N-Out burger with grilled onions
on it. If I ate a burger, I would only, if I had onions on it, it would have to be either sautéed or grilled.
But if it was a big, juicy red onion raw on a burger?
Never.
You would never do that, would you?
Absolutely not.
All right. We're going to use some sea salt. We're going to use red...
I don't think you need that if you're having that red pepper.
Red pepper flake. Well, there's going to be different levels of heat. What I don't have out here is the black pepper, so we're going to put a little bit of black pepper, a little bit of everything, and...
cumin.
And cumin. This is kind of my secret ingredient. I love to put cumin in my guacamole. It gives it a smoky flavor. So the avocado is kind of the canvas and the lime gives it some tartness and some acid, and you have the salt. And then backed up, we're going to get a heat on the tip of the tongue from the red hot chili pepper, and we're going to then get a back bite from the black pepper.
And so what are we going to have this with?
What we're going to have this with from the Mexican online Mexican food distributor, you ordered some tortilla chips.
Yeah.
These are raw, so we have to fry these.
Right.
Also, we have some corn tortilla taco shells, mm-hmm. so we could fry this and we could make maybe...
potato taco or something.
Potato maybe. Taco, a veggie taco finished with the guacamole.
Yeah.
So the guacamole is really versatile. It could be like the star of the show of your little meal, or it could be just an accoutrement,
mm-hmm.
a condiment.
Yeah.
So, yes, we'll do these off camera, but, this is very quick. It's going to take 5 minutes to prepare this.
Okay.
We'll be back in a moment and we'll get going in the kitchen. We're back. We have all of the ingredients put out. We've got two avocados and I've cut them halfway and I've taken out the pits and I've used a spoon to spoon out the meat from the avocado skin. I'm going to save the avocado pits because I will garnish the dish, the finished guacamole with the pit. I've got the lime, I've got the cilantro now that I've chopped finely. I've got the tomato that I've chopped
mm-hmm.
uniformly. I've got the red hot chili pepper that I've almost pulverized.
Dun, dun, dun.
This is the heat. And then I've got the red chili flake. I've got the cumin, the black pepper, the garlic powder, the onion powder, and the salt. So, not including the avocado, there are 10 ingredients that are going into this. So, what I'm going to do first is I'm going to squeeze in the juice of one lime. This is going to prevent, this acid is going to add wonderful flavor, but it's also...
prevent browning.
Yeah, mm-hmm. to prevent the acid's going to prevent the avocado from oxidizing and turning brown. No one likes to get a bowl of brown
avocado. Gross. Right.
No good. Okay, so we've got that. I'm going to put in, I would say I've got here about an eighth of a cup of freshly chopped cilantro. Okay. I'm going to put in, this was one small tomato. Then we're going to put in our red hot chili pepper. I don't want to touch it with my fingers because if I touch my eyes, my face, my nose, I'm going
to be serious pain.
But it's sticky. Oh, accidents in the kitchen. Always.
Just don't break my glass, my bowls. These are like,
they're antiques.
Hanging on by a thread.
Okay. So then I've got basically the wet, fresh ingredients. And now I'm going to put in, this is just where I eyeball it too. I guess I've...
Your pinches and your drams and your...
I'm going to put in...
Smidge.
I'm going to put in like a pinch and a half of sea salt. I'm going to put in a smidge. A smidge of red chili flake. We already have some heat coming from the red hot chili pepper.
Yep.
To give it the onion flavor, we don't want to overwhelm it because Tanya's not a big fan.
I said I like onion flavor. Don't try to make me an onion hater. I'm not.
Tanya's on the onion hating team.
No,
so anybody,
not true.
Anybody who likes
only
onions,
raw onion.
Tell Tanya in the comments. And
only
then I'm going to put...
Onion. Although I do like raw onion in ceviche.
Then I'm going to take a smidge
pepper.
Of black pepper. Maybe a smidge and a half.
Mm.
Then we're going to put in, we're going to add the garlic powder. Don't want to add too much. So again, that might have been a half a pinch. Probably an equal amount of the onion powder and the garlic powder.
Okay.
And then I don't know how many people put cumin in their guacamole, but this is this is my secret, and people say, hey, I like your guacamole, I'm thinking that they like the smoky flavor that they get, I'll put in 2 pinches of cumin. All right, so what we've got, you can see we've got the avocados, and we've got 10 ingredients.
Mm-hmm.
And so other than that,
you're just gonna start mashing.
I'm gonna start, and this is why you need
ripe
avocados, right? Oops, and there's gonna be some that there's gonna be casualty.
Right. So we'll be back in a minute when you're finished with
I'm
your...
I'm gonna continue with the fork.
Yeah, okay. Okay.
So we are back, and what we finished folding and mashing the avocado, you want it to get to a pretty smooth consistency. There's still some small chunks of avocado, which I kind of like. It gives it a little bit of texture. And then, so I served it into a clean bowl, made another dirty dish in the quarantine kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, Tonya. And then I put one of the avocado pits in the center. I don't know where I heard it, but I believe it, that if the avocado pit served in the center of the guacamole will also keep the guacamole from turning brown.
I've heard that too, but I believe that it's the lime. It's the citrus juice.
Maybe it's both.
Maybe.
But
yeah.
The last thing that I want to do at a dinner party is put out a bowl of guacamole and have it turn brown. So
all these dinner parties we're having.
Huh?
All these dinner parties we're having.
I know.
No one's ever coming to our dinner party.
We need to have some dinner parties soon.
Yeah.
What I want to do now is have Tonya be our guinea pig, and she's gonna try it. A little spoonful, you ready?
Uh-huh. Mm. Great.
You like it?
Very good.
Should I add anything before we...
No.
Okay.
Perfect.
All right, so we'll be back. We're gonna fry up a few chips, make this a nice little dish, and go from there.
Great.
All right.
Bye.
Hey, we're back, and shout out first to Tonya. She fried all of the homemade tortilla chips.
Mm-hmm.
It took about 10-15 minutes. It was a lot of work. And now
it's
the
just irritating.
It's irritating.
Yeah.
And the kitchen's really hot right now. But this is the finished product. This is what we would serve maybe at a casual dinner party or an outdoor pool party.
Beautiful.
Yeah, isn't that nice? Shows really well.
Yep.
That is guacamole California style. We even have the California sun right there in the center.
That's right.
So
gorgeous.
It's nice. Please remember, like our video, subscribe to our channel, leave a comment, and share. This is how we're going to grow our YouTube channel and our Facebook page. So thanks for watching, and thanks for supporting the channel. So so long, auf Wiedersehen from the quarantine kitchen, and Halle an der Saale, Germany.
Bye. Adios.
South of the border, down Mexico way, that's where I fell in love when the stars above came out to play. And now as I wander, my thoughts ever stray south of the border, down Mexico way. She was a picture in old Spanish lace, just for a tender while I kissed the smile upon her face. 'Cause it was fiesta and we were so gay, south of the border, Mexico way. Then she sighed as she whispered mañana, never dreaming that we were parting. And I lied as I whispered mañana, 'cause our tomorrow never came. South of the border, I jumped back one day. There in a veil of white by the candlelight, she knelt to pray. The mission bells told me that I mustn't stay. South of the border, Mexico way. The mission bells told me, ding dong, that I must not stay. Stay south of the border, down Mexico way.